Very warm welcome to this special session on metaphysics. Bahut bhari naam hai, right? Metaphysics, yeah? It's a very heavy word, no? But we'll try and simplify it today. We'll try and make sure that we can take from it some things which will actually help us at the end of the day live a better life, and shall I say an easier life. We're all running after so many things. We all have so much pressure, right? So really, the knowledge of metaphysics and its application, jo hai, essentially it is to help us live not just a better life, but an easier life. It's about making things a little more easier for us. Also, it's about enjoying life a little more, isn't it? Yes, we can have our goals in mind. We have duties and responsibilities. We forget to lead a happy life. That's true. Yeah, that's true. And all of us need these reminders, hai na? Aisa koi hai nahi jisko ye reminder nahi chahiye. All of us are sailing in the same boat. We have to constantly remind ourselves that we need to live not just an easier, better life, but a happier life, like Sir just said. It's about feeling happier. It's about feeling light. It's about enjoying this journey of life. So let me quickly introduce myself. I'm Karishma Ahuja. I'm an author and a life coach, and I consider myself to be a lifelong student and practitioner of metaphysics. So metaphysics is a subject which is very close to my heart. It's because I started my journey really understanding the basis of metaphysics, and I'm continuing to understand it, right? Because there's so much that one could understand and learn. And learning never stops, but I'm enjoying the process. So I run a company called Mastermind Training, which is based out of Bombay, and I conduct workshops on mind power, on the law of attraction, and letting go, and forgiveness. You must have heard of a modality called Ho'oponopono. Ho'oponopono again is very close to my heart, because concepts of letting go are very important. हमने बहुत सुना है let go, let go, let go, let go. Everybody knows ना, ऐसा कोई नहीं है जिसको पता है कि let go नहीं करना है. But कितना मुश्किल है. Whoever has tried knows it's so difficult. So really this work that I do is based on helping us practice letting go. Everybody knows everything. It is just about me being a medium and a channel to help you understand how to let go, how to work on these aspects. Okay, that's the kind of work that I do. If you would like to know about specific workshops or courses that I'm doing, then you can visit my website, which is karishmaahuja.com. There you'll understand some specific topics and what all are covered in these courses and topics. Okay, so let's now start with our session for today, which is metaphysics. So firstly, metaphysics, as we can speak the word, makes us realize, oh, it's actually a combination of two words, meta and physics, right? Meta and physics. Well, these words actually come from ancient Greece. Meta, which really means over and above, over and beyond, right? So over and beyond physics, over and beyond seems very obvious. Something more than what you can just see. Something that you can experience. Agreed? Some things that you can simply experience but cannot explain. That's what metaphysics is about. So you know, up to the 1950s and the 60s, metaphysics was considered to be very theoretical. It was considered to be very vague. A very speculative philosophy. But you see, thanks to experiments, thanks to researchers, thanks to all these expansion awareness programs that started to be conducted from the 70s and the late 60s, today metaphysics is not considered to be theoretical. In fact, jo answers metaphysicians ne bahut pehle se de rakhe hain about life, such as who are we? What are we made up of? Where have we come from? What drives us from inside to do things that we are doing? Where are we going to go? You see, answers to all of these questions have been given by metaphysicians. And today, these answers are being accepted as reality, thanks to all the research and experiments being done. Thanks to technology. You heard of Kirlian photography. You can actually see your auric field. You can actually analyze your electromagnetic field. You can actually observe the brain waves. You can actually see how your body is reacting to an outside experience. See, all of this, including research conducted on parapsychology, paranormal phenomena like telepathy, hypnosis. Today we can see how we can consciously do things and how our body is reacting because of all of these things. So because of these experiments, what has emerged is a new psychology of consciousness. Today we hear so much about meditation, but metaphysicians years back have spoken that meditation is a means to achieve higher wisdom, right? So all of that metaphysics is made up of whatever answers metaphysicians have given over the years. Today, the world is being exposed to them because of new research and experiments. So, we should be extremely happy that no matter what, that knowledge is continuing to be fed even in this age, even in this time. So, you know, years back, the great Socrates had said, an unexamined life is a very poor life. What did he mean by that? An unexamined life is a very poor life. What he meant was, if there is no introspection, if there is no awareness of why you're doing what you're doing, where would you like to go henceforth from here? And why you would like to go there? Then what life is this? जब आपको पता ही नहीं है कि आपके अंदर का core being क्या है, तो फिर वो कैसे life होगी? That won't be a rich life. That'll be a poor life. Well, this is what metaphysics does to us. It helps us understand things which make us feel more connected from inside. See, आज का problem ये नहीं है that we are not achieving our goals. You agree? More than ever before, today is a very competitive world. Today we see more talent than ever before, right? But what is happening is, people are achieving their goals, but at the cost of physical health, mental health, emotional health, sometimes at the cost of their relationships, sometimes at the cost of a career. Simply because one area became so important that other areas in life got ignored. This is what is happening. Metaphysics and its practices teaches us how we can lead a very balanced life. How we can always be connected with an inner wisdom so that we don't have to depend on others for answers. Yes, we can always seek guidance. But the final decision that you take must always come from inside. That's what these practices are about. So there is a lot that comes under metaphysics. I'll give you a few examples. Astrology, meditation, philosophy, religion, parapsychology, life after death, reincarnation. Heard of all these topics? But there's so much that one can explore within the range of metaphysics. What you today call as positive thinking, self-help studies, transcendentalism. Ultimately, that's what we feel every meditation practice aims at, right? Transcending over and beyond and moving to higher realms, moving and evolving your consciousness. So all these studies of consciousness, spiritual healing, energy healing, all of this comes within the range of metaphysics. The range is so wide. However, the common denominator in each of these is one and only one. Search. Search for meaning in life. Search for your truth in life. Search for your true purpose in life. Because jab tak ke wo nahi aayega, hame fulfillment nahi milega. It's like aap ek jagah se dusre jagah bhag rahe hain, dusre jagah se teesre jagah bhag rahe hain. So ek consistency, ek stability jo aapko chahiye life mein, wo nahi milti hai. Why? Because something is missing. Something is missing. Your truth is missing. Your purpose is missing. Your true meaning in life is missing. That is what metaphysical studies are about. Right? So, today, let's share some simple but some powerful metaphysical practices. Okay? That actually help us do just that. They help us open ourselves up to greater awareness, such that we will be able to lead a more fulfilled life. Are we ready? No, people here are not ready. No, still they are not ready. They are only 50% ready. Okay, are we ready?
Yes.
Okay, wonderful. You see, enthusiasm is very important. Yeah? The more you are enthusiastic, the more you will receive. Otherwise, aap thoda receive karoge. Agar maine 50% diya, aap 20 receive karoge khali. Because you are less enthusiastic. Enthusiasm comes from the Greek word entheos, which means in spirit, one with God. You've heard of the statement Albert Einstein had made, all I want is to think like how God thinks. It's true, because we can only be successful if we think beyond what our past is, beyond what we have learned from others. This can only happen if you learn from your own experience, no? Otherwise, what you learn from others is their beliefs, right? So, enthusiasm is a great quality which will always help us take much more than others are giving. Enthusiasm. So, enthusiasm ka matlab hai josh, but ek well-structured josh. ऐसा नहीं कि आप किसी चीज़ के पीछे इस तरह से भाग रहे हैं कि आपको होश नहीं. जोश का मतलब ये नहीं कि आप होश खो बैठे, लेकिन enthusiasm का मतलब ये है that you are in high spirits, that you are excited, and when you are excited, your body shows, your posture changes, smile comes on your face, eyes begin to twinkle. That's what happens. Have you seen children? जब उन्हें पता है, जब उन्हें पता है कि मम्मी डैडी कुछ नया टॉय लेकर आए हैं, something is happening, there's some gift for me. You see how excited they get? When in life, we must maintain that kind of enthusiasm. Healing will take place when you are in high spirits, not when you feel कुछ नहीं रखा है यहाँ पे, right ना? The point only is this. That we must always make sure that when we are enthusiastic about life, because the more enthusiastic we are, the easily we receive. For example, if I have a beautiful gift for you, और आपके आँखें बंद हैं, आपका posture ऐसे है कि आप interested नहीं हो, ऐसे लग रहा है जैसे नहीं, अब मत आओ मेरे पास, तो हो सकता है I'll have to wait for some time before I give you the gift. I don't know, maybe he will get angry. He's not in a good mood. Maybe he will not like me coming closer. Right? Hota hai na? Jab koi achhe mood mein nahi hai, you will say, okay, wait, wait, don't talk to him right now. So that's what happens with us. When we are not feeling very good, then we don't receive so many blessings that we deserve. Simply because you are not in the right frequency to receive it. Okay? Let's understand this further as we see some metaphysical practices. Okay? One by one. The first metaphysical practice, this really is something which is the basis which is the basis of our existence, which is the basis of all energy and spiritual work. You know what it is? Number one. And by the way, it's a very common one. When all of us hear it, see it, we feel, ah, yes, of course. But the question is, how many of us practice it? Okay? The very first practice is know thyself. Know yourself. So firstly, who's going to answer? What do we mean by knowing yourself? What does this mean? You are the soul. Yes. But we can only get to that point of exploring a deeper reality in our consciousness if we first of all figure out what is it that makes me happy? How is it that I am projecting myself to others? How do I put forth my ideas? What are my own thoughts? We don't even know what we are thinking. And therefore we end up not feeling good that others don't understand us, right? We often find ourselves complaining, forget it, Papa will not understand, forget it, Mama will not understand, forget it, my children will not understand. So what happens is, when we are not connected with our own selves, we will always find ourselves complaining that people don't understand us. You're absolutely right. Know thyself is about knowing who you really are. But you cannot even get to that point if firstly you don't understand your own thoughts, your own emotions. Today we are running away from our own emotions. Today we are suppressing our own emotions. Today our full focus and attention has come on others. How are they reacting? What are they going to do? Are they going to accept this? Are they going to believe this? What are they thinking right now? How do we protect ourselves? So what happens is, the focus is more on others rather than us at this point in time. We are constantly thinking about ourselves, but in connection with others. A basic fundamental metaphysical practice is know yourself first. Connect with yourself. Connect with your own thoughts. If I were to ask you a simple question, what are you thinking most of the time? Trust me, I don't get answers. We don't know what we are thinking most of the time. Kal kya karna hai? Aaj ke thoughts hi hume yaad nahi hai. Isn't this surprising? See, we are thinking all the time.
Mostly past.
Mostly past. Absolutely. But you see, our past is so scattered. Our thoughts are so scattered that we really don't know most of the times kya chal raha hai mere man mein. So you want to share something?
We are driven away,
absolutely. What is happening is the present is so dominant. Jo chal raha hai itna dominant hai ki hum usme hi uljhe hue hain. So we are constantly fighting with the reality in front of us. We are so busy fighting that there is no time to understand ourselves. But you see, a fundamental metaphysical practice is, if you know yourself better, you will have all the solutions in your life. All the solutions must come to you if you know yourself. If I can attribute one practice to really helping me achieve what I wanted to and what I continue to do in my life, what really gave me a sense of stability and brought an inspiration in my life, was this practice that I'm going to share with you, which was dedicated towards knowing yourself. And that really practice was sitting in silence. So difficult today. We don't get 5 minutes of peace immediately I hear from my clients. 5 minutes nahi milta hai madam, kaise karenge hum? How do we do this? It's so difficult today, right? The fact is, if you are able to spend time in silence with yourself, suddenly you will start to connect better with yourself. You know,
what is an interesting fact about metaphysics? ये जो भी हमने कहा questions थे बड़े बड़े, what is life, what is life after death, what happens to us, where were we before we came here, you see all these questions जिनके answers metaphysics में हैं, वो answers इन seekers को कैसे मिले? Through direct intuitive connection with their inner guidance. That's why metaphysics for years was only a philosophy, कोई proof नहीं था. But really, today what is being accepted and acknowledged even by quantum mechanics and quantum physics and by scientific experiments, that is what metaphysicians have given us. How did they get these answers? From within, from inside. The greatest of wisdom, the most successful people will tell us, will come from inside you. You know why? Because from outside you will only get past judgments, other people's perspectives. This is right and this is wrong. Everybody is only thinking of what is right and what is wrong. But metaphysics says who you are is beyond right and wrong. Who you are is above all of this. So, I have to reach a state where I can clearly see what is right and wrong. Right now, the ones who are telling us what is right and wrong are themselves a part of the problem. Therefore, we also get stuck in problems. So how do we really take ourselves out of this circus is the question. Sitting in silence daily, just as we eat daily. You've seen people, even when they have no time, they'll be grabbing a roll or a sandwich on the road. But they will eat because they understand it's a need of the body. To survive, they have to eat. They manage. We can definitely manage silent sitting also. That's for sure.
If you do regular practice, you can still your mind.
Yes. Then there is no use. See, today what has become a subconscious programming is what was fed repeatedly. That's what we call as a habit. Something that has been done repeatedly goes on to becoming a habit. So sitting in silence must become a habit. Now, by the way, sitting in silence here.
I got something connected to this.
Yes.
But start sitting in silence. Yeah. Initially, so for sure we are not able to make your mind come to that state. But how long does it take generally? When you are doing regular practice, yes. Half an hour to 45 minutes every day to a lot of this practice.
Yes.
But by what time you should be able to have some success?
Until the time you stop judging your success. You will reach a point in time when you are not doing it with any expectation. You are just doing it because you enjoy doing it. Until you reach that stage, you probably are still not there yet. क्या होगा ना जैसे ही आप चालू कर जाओगे आप खो जाओगे. You will enjoy it so much, you will stop expecting, oh, अच्छा ये result तो आया नहीं है life में अभी तक. Wait. अभी तक ये problem तो solve नहीं हुआ है. So until we reach that stage where we are not perceiving the outside as a problem or a challenge, but merely doing this practice because it feeds you. It gives you spiritual food. It feeds your soul. When that happens, you'll know it. You'll just know it. Because it's an experience. What will happen is, in the beginning, naturally there are thoughts. Thoughts will come. And usually, it will take a bit for us to even realize that it is okay to get thoughts. Just don't pay too much attention to them. Let them come, let them go. Don't follow them. The problem is, and the mistake we do is, we become very worked up when thoughts come and we are sitting in silence. Also, we start to feel, oh my God, now that I'm sitting in silence, this thought can become a reality. Now I'm even more upset that I'm thinking these thoughts. So you see, we're only creating further problems. Instead, what we say is, allow them to come, allow them to go, don't pay much attention to them. Slowly what will happen is, aap kho jaoge, you'll be lost in this practice. You'll simply recharge, just as we recharge our batteries when the batteries are low, this practice will become like a recharger for you. It'll just recharge your batteries. You'll start to feel more enthusiastic and more energetic and start to be more open to receiving better good. If you would ask me for beginners, 15 to 20 minutes is recommended on a daily basis, yeah? Unless you're very busy. And if you are very busy, then you must do it for at least 40 minutes. Because then we really need it. Right? Agreed? So yes, 15 to 20 minutes of silent sitting. We will start enjoying the process. And we do this with no expectations. We think of it as our soul food. You have to take time out to feed your soul, because your soul, whatever name you call it soul, call it spirit, call it consciousness, is what is your real recharger. Yeah? If that is not fed, then we get caught up in all worldly things and we'll tend to feel drained. Aapke paas goals hai, ambition hai, but aap apne aap ko bahut chota mehsoos karenge compared to those goals. You'll tend to feel drained, you'll tend to feel lost. Okay? So this is what we can start immediately. What you are talking about is knowing who you are and where you've come from. That we take up much later in metta practices. First, it is essentially going to be about making this a regular practice, but absolutely. For people who have been doing this practice, they are already experiencing much more than beyond the mere physical, right? As he absolutely told us, rightly told us. Okay, let's go to the next practice. Okay. Now, the next practice is again something that all of us know. I told you, all of these things are that you know. But now it's time to practice them, right? Because these things are so simple, they are not taken very seriously. Who knows what forgiveness is? Sorry. Who doesn't know what forgiveness is? Wo sahi question ho gaya na, aaj ke zamane mein. Everybody knows. Forgive karo, forgive, forgive, let go, let go, let go. It is very difficult. It is very difficult because we are treating forgiveness as a exercise. We are taking it like a task we have to perform. But what we have strongly been recommended in metaphysical work and practices is forgiveness is a constant process. Karte jana hai aapko. It's not something ki aaj ho gaya, aaj ka dose khatam. It's something that we need to constantly work on. Now, this is not what I actually wanted to tell you. These are things we already know. But basically, what I wanted to tell you is that it's not just important to forgive people. It's extremely important to let go of mistakes that you are making, okay, of your own past. Also, of events. Yeah? Trust me. In my journey with clients, the most difficult are events to forgive. I mean, how do you forgive an event? How do you forgive an event which devastated everything in your life? Very difficult, right? But you see, since all of us are connected, all of us have memories of such events. Ye jo hamara sudden gussa itna nikalta hai, wo kahan se nikal raha hai? Somewhere we have memories of the past which are constantly running, no? Continuously running within us. So therefore, here is a practice I strongly recommend. Whenever I tend to feel very drawn in a certain situation and affected by something that is happening, here is what I tell myself. Karishma, relax. Now you don't say Karishma, relax. Okay, you have to take your name and say, relax.
You should be an awesome.
Yes, relax. Because you see, wo forgiveness nahi hai khali, ki aap baith kar, aankhein band karein, aur kisi ko forgive karein. Ye jo daily aapki life hai, jo din bhar hota hai na, jaise ki cab bahut der se mili, usme bhi gussa andar chala jata hai. Similarly, kuch delay ho gaya, usme se bhi gussa aa gaya, disappointment ho gayi. So, constantly keep telling yourself to relax. What will happen is, today's baggage is not carried tomorrow. And tomorrow's baggage will not be carried the next day. Just tell yourself, relax. Relax. Yeah. Yes, yes. See, sabse pehle to all of us can treat forgiveness more as a process, like I said. It's a very powerful ritual. Okay? Now, one of the easiest ways you can use, since you have asked me this question, to help forgive other people, okay, is just as you have taken a bath, okay, for your physical body, right? Immediately after that, think of three people who you want to forgive daily. Just let their thought come to your mind. Immediately, unka face aa jayega, their image will come, right? No, asking yourself, okay, who is it that I need to forgive? The universe is going to guide you. God is waiting for you to do this exercise. So not three, 10 aa jayenge. Okay, but you stop at three for a day. Tobi, you must forgive. It's not easy. It's not easy. But if you are working on your own energy, ye samajh lijiye life mein, for you, it may not have been your mistake in a situation that somebody took away your money or somebody cheated us. We had nothing to do, but we suffered. What is your job? What is your lesson in the situation is to learn to manage your energy. Aap dikhaiye ki aap is situation mein bhi apni energy kaise manage kar rahe hain. That is your job. If you are able to pass this test, you will get back what you have lost. This is the test you need to pass. You need to show how you are managing your energy in different situations. यही हमारे लिए सबसे बड़ा lesson है. इसीलिए ही हम relax, relax अपने आप को क्यों बोल रहे हैं? ताकि हम अपनी energy control में रखें. So that, you know, we don't lose it on others. So, not just every day after bath, think of people you want to forgive and just say, I forgive you completely. I forgive you completely. I forgive you completely. Even 2 minutes daily is teaching your subconscious mind that we must forgive. You see, what really hurts me and really what brought me more into this practice, because see, a lot of my work revolves around forgiveness. And I think one reason why I'm drawn so much to it was because I struggled with it. I really struggled with it. Yes. We are holding on to why things happened and why me. And we are holding on to the fact that I didn't do anything. Phir bhi kyun hua mere saath? But the fact is, the bigger metaphysical truth is, we are all connected. Let's go through some more points, then we will understand this point even better. For now, a very important metta practice is continuously forgiving. It's not one day, it's not tomorrow, it's not day after. Whenever you meet me, what is one practice you will share with me you're doing every day? Forgiveness. That's what the point is here. Metaphysics mein forgiveness ka importance utna hi hai jitna khane ka, jitna pani peene ka, utna hi importance metaphysics mein forgiveness ka hai. And remember, all throughout the day, tell yourself, take your name, because your subconscious mind only follows your name and your voice. Take your name and say, relax, and start repeating it a few times. You will start feeling much better. Again, as sir rightly said, ek din karne se fayda nahi hoga, aapko continuously karna hai.
But what happens, you know, sometimes there are people who keep you or annoy you again and again, time and again.
So whenever now you get bugged, take your name and say, relax, 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 pass the test. Jab wo din aayega na, jab wo aapko bug karna band kar denge, iska matlab aapki memory erase ho gayi past ki. That means you are successful. Daily practice karna. Every day. That's my point. मैंने आपसे कहा था, what I'm going to share with you, you know. But I'm only adding an extra element. It's a daily practice. Forgiveness is a daily practice, friends. Daily practice. And the, yes, and the reason, I'll come to you. The reason what I am even further stressing this point is, bachpan se humne suna hai, forgive. Do we teach children how to? Have we sat down with members of our family and told them, this is how you will forgive? When will we start doing this? It's high time, because people are suffering. You see, today as adults, we would not be suffering if our parents or any elders in the family would bring us together. Schools can teach. Schools tell us forgive. But are they teaching children how to? Tell me one place where they are teaching them how to forgive. We are not. So you start now. You start. You start getting members of the family. In fact, I have one special video just on this on YouTube. Get all the members of the family together. Let everybody close their eyes. And let everybody come up with one person who they want to forgive mentally. And tell them, let's together keep repeating, I forgive this person completely. Make children repeat few times thinking of the person they want to forgive. I forgive this person completely. Now, what is the beauty in this practice? You are not only teaching them that you must forgive, you are showing them how. And you are making this a daily practice. Yes.
Then family members that have we forgive.
Yeah.
But the other members, they don't stay.
Yeah.
They have their selfish view.
Yes.
How that will happen?
So, let me remind you of another metaphysical truth. There is no out there. If I see something in someone, I must be having it. Maybe chote percentage mein, lekin mujh mein bhi hai. Jaise ki, agar main aapko janti hoon, to bahar kahin milenge, main aapko notice karungi. Par agar main aapko janti nahi hoon, aap mujhe 10 jagah dikhein, I will not be able to notice you. Why? Because we have not met. We only see in others what we already know. This is a metaphysical truth. Yes. We only see what we already have. Otherwise, you would not notice in others. Well, this is the lesson we are talking about. Let go. Relax. Aapka naam lijiye aur kahiye apne aap ko. Relax. Yes, sure. Other person should first do it.
Start once, you know.
Yeah, true. It's a chain effect, absolutely. That's why doing it in front of your children is very important. देखिए आप अकेले में करें उतना effective नहीं होगा.
वो life situation से देखते हैं ना, अभी parents कैसा behave कर रहा है, तो वो क्या है, monkey do, monkey see, monkey.
Correct. That's what is the basis of children, ना? They'll see and they will do. So let's practice forgiveness खुलेआम आज के बाद, right? In fact, अच्छी चीजें जो हैं हम अकेले में कर रहे हैं. झगड़ा हम जोर से कर रहे हैं, राइट? वी आर शाउटिंग लाउडली बट वी प्रे अलोन. इट्स नाउ टाइम टू फॉरगिव टुगेदर, टू प्रे टुगेदर, राइट? एंड सम ऑफ अस हैव बीन डूइंग इट, एंड जो करते हैं दे कीप सेइंग बहुत फायदा हुआ है इन द एटमॉस्फेयर इन द हाउस. ओके, ऑल राइट, लेट्स गो टू द नेक्स्ट प्रैक्टिस. नाउ अगेन इन मेटाफिजिक्स इसका इम्पोर्टेंस बहुत हाई है. ओके, इन फैक्ट some people say ye nahi to kuch bhi nahi. Love. Now again, we all know you have to love, you have to love yourself, you have to love others, but I am here to add something extra in every point, right? I am bringing out the most important aspects in metta practices to you. You see, yes, loving yourself and loving others is the basis. But first of all, we must understand why. Because then it will come out naturally.
Unconditionally.
Why? It is said in the book of Genesis and in every spiritual text, the world began when God spoke. God spoke and the world originated. The world was created by God and He spoke and it all came up, right? Are they saying God shouted? Are they saying God was angry and the universe came up? No. Clearly, the basis of creation is love. Anything beautiful is created out of love. This is the fundamental truth. We cannot create when we are not feeling love. That is why in my Law of Attraction workshop, what are we practicing? We are practicing really how to raise our energy and vibration And if you are not feeling love, chances are you may not be feeling very good. Can you feel good when you are not feeling love? You cannot. You see, love is an emotion that will always keep you inspired in life. Aapki energy hamesha high rahegi. In fact, ye emotion ko aapko kaise zyada se zyada pour out karna hai in your daily life, that is what we want to practice. We all know. We know we need to love. But how to bring it out, that's important. Am I right? You see, metaphysical practices and tools aim at making you feel love in your daily activities. In your daily activities. It's about feeling love when you're in the kitchen. It's about feeling love when you're outside with friends. Every activity, do with love. Approach the activity with love. Now ask ourselves, are we doing it? Are we doing it? No, because we are not even conscious when we are doing the activity. It's just happening. It's like a routine. It's a task which needs to be accomplished. But imagine what can be created out of a simple routine activity if you do it with love. Real transformation will take place when we approach our activity. Let's break down our activities. Let me from now on sip my tea and coffee in the morning with love. Let me smile and sip my tea and coffee. Let me wake up my children with love. Yes, I have to be firm, because parents tell me, see, children, don't get up. Be firm, but make sure you're coming out of love. Yeah, not out of frustration. Ki ye to roz karna hai, this is my life. No. Come out of love. See how you can get into an activity with love. Now, let's share with you something that can help you bring in more love. Okay? Whether you call it spirit, whether you want to call it source energy, you want to call it universe, you want to call it God, use whatever name appeals to you. But talk to that power, that source, and say, please do through me. Please do through me. It's amazing how suddenly the posture gets corrected, no matter how tired you are. Suddenly, wo exercise na rotiyan belne ka, aise lag raha hai ki aap apna heart ko expand kar rahe ho. Rotiyan nahi bel rahe ho. Aapka heart badhta ja raha hai. Aapka love badhta ja raha hai. Jo aap fruits kaat rahe ho na, suddenly lagega fruits nahi kaat rahe hai, apna ego ja raha hai. Suddenly, doing routine task will seem so much fun. Not only that. When you start putting in more love into your profession and use your talents out of more love, then you really get to the next level in life. Then you create something as spectacular as this universe that was created by God. So yes, we have to love, but here I'm talking about how you can bring love in every activity. Dear God, dear universe, please do through me, and see the beauty that unfolds. Okay? Let's go to the next point. Asking is equal to praying. Asking is equal to praying. Why? Well, metaphysicians believe there is but one universal mind, one primal energy, and all minds are inseparable from this one universal mind. That means we are all part of the main pool. So, point to be noted. Every time you are speaking, you are sending your words into the main pool. Every time you are speaking and thinking, you are sending your words into the main pool. Point to be noted. Every word is an affirmation. not just 10 minutes of repetition I'm doing in the morning at night. I am beautiful, I'm happy, I'm healthy. Only those are not my affirmations. What you are saying and speaking and thinking on a daily basis, that is what is going into the main pool. Every thought is a prayer. Every thought is a prayer, because there is nothing that will not go into the main pool, into the main universal mind, because you are inseparable from the main universal mind. So whatever you are saying, all the complaining, all those thoughts of not feeling good about yourself and your life, about how unsupported you are, how unsupported your friends and family are, every thought is going into the main pool. So the next time you speak, yes, yes, absolutely. So my point is, if you want to practice this in the right way, then keep repeating. Every word is a prayer. Every word is a prayer. Every word is a prayer. I'll tell you kya hoga, you'll stop saying the wrong words. First of all is, the most difficult to do is to stop using abusive language, to stop saying words like, I hate you, I'll kill you, you are ugly. Suddenly, by keeping on saying every word is a prayer, every word is a prayer, the people with the worst of angers and tempers, suddenly they get calmer. Few days of doing this, imagine. Why? Because your consciousness, consciousness really begins to feel and observe how this word is making you feel. That's what the practice is about. Every word is a prayer. Every word is a prayer. We wouldn't offer junk food on the altar. You would only have beautiful clothes. You would only have lovely offerings, beautiful fresh flowers at the altar. Remember, every word you speak about yourself and others is going to your altar. There's a client of mine who says, after you have told us this, I actually go and see my altar more number of times than before, because it is playing so much in my mind. Oh my God, I'm speaking such wrong words. I actually go and see my altar, because psychologically I begin to feel I'm dirtying it with my words. But this is one way to bring more awareness into your words. Every word is a prayer. Please use right words. Otherwise, we cannot think of connecting with inner wisdom. We cannot go deeper in metta practices if we don't speak the right words. All words have power. All words have power.
Yes. Logical mind.
Yes.
Every time he asks for the proof, whether I have my brain was connected with the universe.
Yes. Yes, yes, absolutely. Very true. Okay. The last but not the least. This is how we will begin our
this
mornings. Yes. Yes. Yeah, ask and you receive. See, why I'm using the word asking, is good you raise this point, is what I'm trying to say is, whenever you speak a word, you have asked for it in your experience by default. So asking does not only mean I want the car, I want the house, I want the health. Every word is a petition made to God, because it's going into the main pool. And why am I stressing so much on words? Because you are using the same words, if you notice. On a daily basis, most of us are using the same words. You see, all of these words are going out into the main universe, into the universal mind, the cosmic mind, into the spirit source energy that you can call God. And it's coming back to you as an experience. So you are literally asking for experiences in your life through the words you are speaking. So what is important is not what you want. What is important is, what words are you speaking? Because you will undoubtedly get more of what matches the energy of your words. Always, at all times. This is the law. Okay? Let's go to the next one. Next one is a reminder. Giving yourself a reminder that within you is limitless power. See, we all know it again. It's about reminding yourself. Don't you tell your children, Mama's there, Papa's there, don't worry, why are you crying? I'm there, no? Aap bolte nahi hai? We say, right? We say it. You have to remind yourself too that within you is this beautiful source energy which is bigger than any problem, any challenge that you are facing. To help you understand this point better, I will request you to close your eyes. Close your eyes. Relax. Make sure your body is feeling absolutely relaxed. There is no strain. There is no tension. Close your eyes. Relax. Now, take one hand and keep it on your heart. Slowly start to feel your heartbeat. Keep your hand on your heart. Slowly start to feel your heartbeat. This is one of the best ways you start connecting with yourself. On the right is your spiritual heart. As you start to feel your heartbeat, repeat with me the following words. The power within me is greater than any challenge I am currently facing in my life. I give thanks to this power within me to give me powerful solutions. I give thanks to this power within me to help me experience the true meaning of life. I give thanks to this power within me for giving me self-mastery. Now you can relax while I repeat the same words again. Just relax. The power within me is greater than any challenge I am currently facing in my life. Okay? Whenever we feel stressed and overwhelmed with a situation, all you need to do is to simply close your eyes and remind yourself that this problem cannot overrule your life. Why? It's too small as compared to the power within you. Daily, wake up saying the power within me is greater than any disappointment I am facing, any fear I am facing, any challenge I am facing, any problem I am facing, whether it's fear, whether it's anger, whether it's frustration, whether it's aggression, whether it's disappointment, whether it's rejection. Just simply tell yourself the power within me is greater than this problem. This challenge I am currently facing. And then always end this little prayer and talk with God with gratitude. I give thanks to the power within me for bringing me beautiful solutions. I give thanks to this power within me for helping me live my life. in the best possible way I can. I give thanks to this power within me for blessing me with self-mastery. I give thanks to this power within me for taking care of me and my life. That is the beauty. That is the sweetness of faith and surrender. Remind yourself, and trust me, as you keep having this talk, suddenly the calmness comes. Suddenly the relaxation comes. Suddenly you just know what you need to do. This is one of the most powerful practices in metaphysics. Reminding yourself that the power within you is greater than this problem or this challenge that I'm now facing. I've covered up a few practices. I have not got into details of all the practices, but I have given you a few tips on how you can really start this journey using these tools, which are simple but extremely powerful if we do them daily. I would just like to end my session saying one thing my metaphysical practice has taught me. Nothing in our present situation can block the cosmic intention, God's intention, that you and I succeed in life. I don't think we are meant to fail. Nothing in my present or nothing in your present can stop you from living a good life, provided you dedicate not just tomorrow or day after, but today itself to become a better version of yourself. You must demonstrate that you are managing your energy better. Every day, do something that you can be proud of. Speak a better word, speak a kinder word, do something sweet for someone. Keep quiet at the right times, not retaliate, and simply prove your point. Put more love into your daily activity. Remind yourself that the power within you is greater. See, when you do these things, you become a better version of yourself. And then success will come, money will come, health will come. Most importantly, the basic aim of every metaphysical practice, true fulfillment in life, will come. Let's start today, this very moment, to become better versions of ourselves. I've enjoyed doing this for you. Thank you so much. Namaste, and see you soon. Thank you.